not a drinker, just an overthinker. Just another lover looking for a little luck. Yeah, lately I've been thinking that maybe I'm not good tonight. But I promise not this time. When I get lonely, I'll be all on me. Looking at the old me, I'll feel a little safer in my own arms tonight. But I've got trust issues, cause people have things lying issues. If we just stick together,
every day is like is music mode for me.
Sure.
But it doesn't mean that every day I'm going to make a song. I feel like the music needs to speak to me first before, because you can't just go in with lyrics like, okay, yeah, it's not gonna be authentic to me as an artist. Like,
welcome to a brand new episode of A Walk with Mel. People, it is your favorite show on Cape Town TV channel 260 on your DSTV. Today it's all about music, it's all about art, and I'm excited to be chatting to this wonderful artist, Key the Berg. Said I said it correctly, right? Welcome to the show, and thank you so much to everyone for tuning in. I mean, I'm loving your work. I've listened to your album Behind the Scenes. So dope. And I like the story of how you made it. Before we get into that, let's talk about you, who you are, and where you're from.
Okay, so my name is Keith Bergstedt, as everyone knows already. Uh-huh. I was born in Piketberg.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's sort of like where my mom has family in St. William, but uh-huh. She lived in Vredenburg, and that's obviously where she met my dad. Uh-huh. And then we moved around a lot. Like, I've lived in places like Riversdale.
Yo.
And Heidelberg and Plettenberg Bay. That's where I went to grade one when
okay.
I was in school. And then I've been in the Cape like most of my life.
Lekker.
So that's like where I have family all over.
That's so dope, because you've got an idea of what it's like in different cities.
Yes.
Basically. Mm. What was life growing up for you?
It was fine. I feel like it was a very musical journey, because I know my dad's brother, mm-hmm. he used to like watch concert DVDs, mm-hmm. and he would give my dad concert DVDs, and I would like watch this in Amplifier, and that's like where I was introduced to Michael Jackson. And when I was little, I feel like my mom and my dad would tell me stories like where I was like, I think it was at someone's 21st, where I just got up on stage and I was like started dancing.
No, thank you.
And I was like, I don't remember these things, but I feel like it's been since I was little that.
So
I
do you think that was your introduction to music?
Yes.
Uh-huh,
uh-huh. I remember watching the Thriller video like over and over again.
That was your thing. Mm. And when did you decide that, you know what, I want to do this, man? Even music, dude.
I don't know.
Vibe.
You just, you feel it, and you know, like, it's not something.
You feel like it found you, maybe?
Yeah, I feel like you just know, like, when you listen to music and you make music, you feel like you just want to do it. And
sure.
I don't think there's something that you can, like, that leads you to it. It's like more like you have to. It needs to find you.
I get you.
It's not something you can force.
I get you. That's so dope, because that's like a gift also. Then, I mean, you went to, obviously, finishing high school. You went to go study, and you decided to go into performing arts.
Yes.
Let's talk about that journey. What
so
was it like?
I was at the Stage Performing Arts Studio.
Lovely.
Last year.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a very nice experience, because I did ballet.
Lovely.
I did jazz. I did musical theater choreography. And I sort of like, as I did musical theater, I sort of like, I found a new love for that as well. Because
wow.
Now I know how musicals work, choreography and stuff like that. So that was like kind of like a basis for me, because when I go into the industry now and it's like a Broadway or mm-hmm. even like a musical production here in Cape Town, I know some of the musicals now. So I would learn, then I know that you learn the songs first, you audition with the songs, you
sure.
find out what the characters are in the story, how they
so
do that. So that's kind of like
amazing. And then after that,
then I went to Northland College mm-hmm. This year now. That's where I made new friends.
Lovely.
And stuff like that. So as you'll hear on the album when it comes out, like my best friend mm-hmm. is Heinrich Anana,
mm-hmm.
who also helps me with some of the songs, like when I'm
so
stuck
dope.
With melodies or something, because he was here yesterday and
amazing.
And we recorded a new song yesterday mm-hmm. for the album, so now it's done.
Amazing.
So yeah, him, and then there's another collaborator, Haley, mm-hmm. that's mm-hmm. also on the album, that I also met at Northland College.
Amazing.
So there's a lot of people that you, as you go along in your journey, that you mm-hmm. learn to collaborate with,
I
and
get
you learn
you.
To and you listen what their sound is, and like you that's how
and
you
that's how you grow.
Yes, that's how you grow.
It goes
yes.
word mm. man. And I love the process. I mean, we spoke before we did the interview, you told me about the process of how you
yeah.
made the album
mm-hmm.
and about the covered vibe, and
yes.
I was like, yo, I always see it on TV, in the movies you always see it,
yeah,
but I've never met someone, and when I heard that, I was like, wanted to do this interview. I was like,
okay, cool.
like so excited for that, man. Tell us about the process. How did that happen, and why did you decide make that decision?
I heard like last year, I think it was last year or the year before, I'm not sure, where I heard that you, because acoustics is very important when you're recording and in a room or something. So I was figuring out a way of how to like use mattresses or use egg cartons or something to make it sound, because when I put the mic in the middle of the room, you could hear there's like an echo thing without the reverb, and that doesn't really necessarily sound nice.
I get you.
So I had to figure out a way to, you know, improvise. So then my dad brought home these cupboards, but when he brought it home, I didn't really think of the idea.
Obviously,
And then when I went into the room the other day, I was like, because I was sort of like afraid to ask my dad, because it came just now, and then there's like this glass thing that was in it that you need to take out. So I was like, can we take it out and we just see if it works? And ever since that day, it's like, that's the
that's your studio.
Yeah,
that's your studio, bro. So for us, because I can record. Love it. And then you also write your own music.
Yes, I prefer to write everything myself.
Where do you find inspiration for your music in general?
Like, it literally comes with people. Like, it depends on the different artists I'm listening to. It depends on which artist released music in that week or that month. Yeah, so like recently I got the idea for the last song we finished yesterday. Like, I was listening to Khalid's last album.
Okay.
So it kind of has that type of vibe.
I
and
get
then when
you.
It comes to writing lyrics, I really look up to like people like Taylor Swift, and because people who write their own music is really like, I want to do that. I want to be able to say that I wrote
get
that.
Or, what you're saying. Yeah. Shout out to you, man. My ek wil mos nou daai cupboard sien. Dis dit ding. Ek wil mos nou daai vibe sien daar binne. So we're going to go right to that cupboard and then we'll take a quick break, people. It is a walk with Mel. Make sure you follow and like him on all social media platforms, as well as Ask Mel Your Pal on Facebook and Mel Rogleza on Instagram, people. Yay, yay. It's a walk with Mel.
At High Street Fashion, we offer consumers access to famous UK high street fashion brands at unparalleled value. Until now, most of these brands have not been available in South Africa. Our ranges change daily, and every day brings a treasure hunt of trendy fashion. The priority for the original brand owners is to work with retailers like us to find new markets to avoid these end-of-season items going to landfill in the UK, and most importantly, protecting the environment. South Africa is the perfect destination because of the opposite seasons and the massive demand for these brands at affordable prices. Our source in the UK has worked tirelessly with brand owners of Pretty Little Thing, Boohoo, Very UK and ASOS over many years to find a solution for excess stock and at the same time project the integrity of these brands. These brands now embrace the resale of their products into a new secondary market. So head on over to High Street Fashion in Blue Route Mall today, where you'll be sure to find top brands at the lowest prices.
In a dumb, stupid life. Just tell me when it gets too much. Tell me when it gets too much. I really could use the pain to heal from the inside. I don't know what's killing me. The lies on the tears the most. But maybe if we all realize it's all just a dream. It's all just a cry.
As you can see, this is life of an artist. Like, this is what it looks like. If I go to places, people be like, yo, what's your desktop look like this? But this is what it looks like. So let me just, yeah, so I use an app called FL Studio or Fruity Loops.
Okay, no, but that is a strawberry.
FL Studio is like the shorter thing for it. And yes, this is where I record vocals. This is where I make the beats out of samples.
So you make the beats yourself?
Yes and no. Like, I construct it. So as you can hear, That was one sample, okay. And then that one sample consists out of something we call stems. So then you get the bass, you get the flute, you get that put together formulates that one sample. So then I took the bass out of the first sample to form the first verse. So then the first verse will then go into, and then it will sound like this.
Good day, baby.
Yeah.
did you make those?
Yes, I put the stains and everything together. Like I had to find, I found a drum that fits. Yeah, so I do. Yes.
And what song is this for? Is it still happening?
So, yes, this is done. So this is called "Said I Would Be." So then the intro will sound like.
It's been way too long. It's been way too long. Oh no, I wasn't on my dog.
So then this will be like the intro
thing. It's been way too long. It's been way too long. Oh no.
And first this.
Said I've been drinking hardcore overthinking.
Oh yeah. It's a vibe song.
So it was actually my cousin. He explained to me how
it works.
How it works. So if you look at, because the chorus was something that was really hard to let me just see
this here.
So all those backing vocals were it was, I had to do it over and over just to make sure that it's but this hasn't been mastered yet, so it sounds a bit rough now. But once it's
but
done.
But you're basically self-trained.
Yes.
You would
yes,
say
yes,
someone trained you. And with your vocal, did you have vocal training?
Not really. Like it was like when I was at the stage, like we would like prep for exams and stuff, and then a guy named Peter would like play and then show me this is what we do and this is fix this and not make it so, but not like intense vocal training.
So was it natural talent you can work with? Well, I just ordered and well done. And I know that this will just will become like bigger things for you. I know.
I hope so, yeah.
Yay! How it makes you feel.
And we are back, people. Yo, Keith is in the building. It's music, it's arts, it's alles. I like your vibe, really. And I love when people create their own, man. Mm. And I love that people, when you don't have the resources, then maak jy eie ding. And that's exactly what you gemaak het. And I love that, man. So, well done. The album name, can you say it was when I got the kids in it?
It's called Kleinomania.
Kleinomania, man. It's a new word for me. What is the meaning and what is the inspiration for that?
So, what the album means is that the album is filled with songs like, I feel like people will relate to this album because I feel like there's lots of people out there who've had their heart broken or who've been bullied or who've been that feeling that you just don't want to get out of bed. So that's basically what Kleinomania stands for. It's like it's a name of the word, like that feeling you get when you don't want to get out of bed, whether it's you want to just stay home or whether you're sad or heartbroken or something. It's just it describes that.
Yo, that's well said. And then tell us, take us through the process of making the album. No? I heard you, like you said, you finished a song yesterday. You did make like three of one day, three of one day gemaakt, and two of another five. Like, what was the process of making
It depends, like, whenever, like, every day is like is music mode for me.
Sure.
But it doesn't mean that every day I'm going to make a song, because I need to get inspired because writing lyrics or something. Because, and this is something that my cousin always makes fun of me. Whenever we have a session together, my cousin and I never have lyrics. I like to make it up as I go along because I feel like the music needs to speak to me
first,
because you can't just go in with lyrics like, okay, yeah, it's not gonna be authentic to me as an artist. Like, I like when I hear it, I'll be like, okay, I have an idea, let's do this. So, and then before I put it out, I will always change things. Like yesterday, I had to re-record the chorus again yesterday because it felt like it wasn't really what I wanted to
put
out.
And you know what you want.
Yes, and you know what you go for, and that's just
I wanted to ask you actually, what sound are you going for? Is there a specific sound that you're going for?
So I would consider myself, the album is very poppy, but not like poppy in the sense of there's like R&B influencing and there's trap influencing, because especially with the bass. And so like the opening song is called Pray For Me, and I felt like that was a very good way to open the album, like get people energized and just when the beat comes in. And
Liquor. And then what inspired the song Sick Of Me?
So Sick Of Me is how do I put this, like, to make it like short and sweet? It's like when you go, it's like when you lose friends or you lose relationship, it's like
you feel
like, and it feels like, you know what, it looks like you've got what you wanted, like I'm not good enough anymore, so just guess that you're sick of me, because that's just, you get what I'm saying. So it's like the song takes you on a journey of how to, like this, the opening line in the second chorus is picturing my future without you. Is like, I'm now looking, what is gonna be like without you, because I lost a friend or I lost a person that I found, you know.
That's deep, what? Because we're, you know, so yeah. And then quarantine, obviously quarantine. The song Quarantine was obviously inspired by, the lockdown life.
I actually wrote Quarantine when I was at my mom's house. I got the idea.
Okay.
And it actually started out on a voice memo. I think I still have the original voice memo on my phone.
So dope.
And I was like, this is so cool. And I wanted to feel like, because everybody's talking about quarantine and wearing masks and stuff, so I wanted to do something creative, like, what if I can quarantine my feelings for someone? And I was like, okay. And
that's dope.
I thought to make it into a song, like, what if you can quarantine your feelings? You just, because everybody's like, who goes through breakups will be like, I just want to quarantine my feelings.
That is like dope.
It never happened, yeah, because it's like a disease
so
or something.
Cool.
Yeah.
And tell me, what does lockdown taught you? What has this experience? Because I mean, I think lockdown was heavy for all of us. But what do you think? What do you take away from the experience?
I feel like lockdown has its pros and its cons, because I feel like a pro is I got to finish the album. Which I never thought, because when I was studying and I didn't really have time for, you know, music and stuff like that. But also lockdown, you know, messes up your sleep hours and you wake up late or you go to bed late. And I feel like that's kind of a con.
And then, I mean, back to the album now, what do you want people to, I mean, in general, to take away from your music?
So I just want people to be like, relate and be like, I also went through that. Finally, someone put like a name for it and, oh, this is what I was feeling the other day. That's kind of what I want.
And tell us, what hurdles have you faced? I mean, making an album, I mean, it klinget lekker my album te maak, but I know what it's like to produce your own. And it sounds easy, but then when you start, it's just like, ooh, is there now nog challenges? Ooh, is there now, what hurdles have you faced?
So,
and how have you overcome it?
I wanted when I was the idea for an album started when I was in high school, but I didn't have all of the like beat or all of the collaborators that I wanted to work with. And the thing is, lots of people always want money, or people
and especially when you start, you don't have.
Yeah, you don't have. You have to like start with something. And because there was this one guy that I worked with, who wasn't really like his heart wasn't really in it, so that was kind of like, that's also like a collaboration that didn't happen. But the people that I've collaborated with, I was really lucky, because they were like, yes, let's do it. And and I felt that was really cool, because not everyone is always open to making music and stuff like
And what do you take away from this journey? What does music teach you?
Like, I feel like music teaches you to be yourself, to be authentic to yourself, to express yourself in ways that other people can't.
Sure.
Like, if you struggle to find the words to explain your situation, you can always play people a song like, listen to this is how I feel. And yeah, that's kind of what I wanted to do.
In the last few questions, I mean, you did mention to me that before you released the EP, you had, I mean, before you released the album, you had EPs.
Yes.
Us about that music.
So that was
and why
like
you
just,
made it.
That was just like a jumpstart, just to test. Like, okay, so I just wanted to feel what it felt like to be able to say, okay, I have music on Spotify, I have music on iTunes, like, go listen to this and so on.
Lovely.
Like, that wasn't like me as an artist, that was just like songs that nobody was gonna hear anyway.
Sure,
so
that I get
was just
you.
Like,
just
yeah.
to see what it's like,
yes.
yeah. And then the vision for you ultimately as an artist, because you obviously an actor too, you, I mean, you do more, you're performing artist, obviously. What is the vision for you ultimately?
I want to be able to say, like, I want to be able to specialize in all three.
Which
like,
is?
Like, it's music and singing, dancing and acting.
Love it.
So I want to be able to like dance in my music videos or be able to say, I was on TV, I acted in this. And so that's kind of what I...
Because and then where can people get your music? Free album in your life and so forth.
I actually have a list. I have to think now. So it's on, the main three are Spotify, Apple Music, iTunes. It's on Deezer, Napster, I think, but I don't think that's available in our country yet.
Must find the other means of my dad. Oprah Kiki Show. So kind of Oprah Kiki Show can buy Napster, correct?
And then it's Amazon Music, Google Play Music.
Yeah.
So it's basic. It's everywhere. It's on Instagram. It's on TikTok. It's everywhere.
Lovely. And social media, where can people catch you?
So on Instagram, I am on Facebook, and I'm on Twitter as well,
Twitter,
but I don't
as,
really use.
Yeah, what's the name?
So it's Bergstedt Keith.
Uh-huh.
And then on Instagram, it's Keith Bergstedt.
Lovely. And any advice? I mean, if there's young ones watching, it really wants to follow in your footsteps. What advice would you give them?
My advice would be always trust your gut. If your gut were to say something is off, trust your gut.
Sure.
Don't wait for other people to make a move in the industry. You need to. If there's auditions, go for it, because you never know what can happen. Like, auditioned recently for something, Van Adam Sir. There was a casting call for that.
Lovely.
And when it came out, I was like, I'm not even going to audition because it's a big thing. Yeah. So lots of people were probably going to audition. I wasn't going to get it. And then Abby, who's with me in Witsun, messaged me the other night and she told me that they're still looking for someone. So then the next day I sent in my audition and the next day I got it. So it was
and I thank you for
it was a very nice experience.
It was amazing. And now that you're saying that about advice to people, what advice if I say no for you for younger Keith or voice note can still know, no? For maybe if your younger, way younger self, what advice would you give to your younger self?
I would be like, don't be so hard on yourself. Like you don't need to prove yourself to make a dent in wherever. Like even if it's just one person listening to your music or 10,000 people, it takes that one person to make a difference. That one person can make or break you.
Woo! People, there you have it. Yeah. That one person can make or break you. Make sure that you check him out on all social media platforms. Crazy Music, let's support our own people. It is a walk with Mel. The show will be repeating Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. on Cape Town TV, channel 263 on your DSTV. Thank you so much for tuning in and thank you so much for joining us. And we wish you all of the best, man.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.